This screencast shows how you can use COSMOtherm to predict and visualize the way molecules interact with each other. Take, for example, water and acetic acid. We know that between these molecules there's going to be hydrogen bonding, but we don't know anything about the most common interaction. However, we can use COSMOtherm to predict the most probable or the lowest energy interaction between these two molecules. So let's do that by first selecting our components. Water's at the top, and we should be able to scroll through and find acetic acid. So here's acetic acid. Press Get Selection. And then on the Mixtures tab, let's select some non-zero concentration for each, maybe 0.5 and 0.5. Choose the checkbox here for Compute Contact Statistics. And then let's create the geometry files of the contacts. And in this case, we can either choose the most probable contact or the lowest energy. Let's do the lowest energy contact between them. Actually, for these two molecules, the interactions are the same. Now we press the Add button and press Play. When we close this and look at our text output, we'll see that geometry files have been created with the file type XYZ, and they're between compound 1 and compound 1, so that's water and water, between compound 1 and compound 2, so water and acetic acid. And if we scroll down farther and look at for compound 2, again, interactions between the molecules and for acetic acid interacting with itself. So now the only thing we have to do is open these geometry files, these XYZ files, and look at the interaction. So I've already downloaded a program called JMOL that allows you to visualize this. So let me open JMOL. It's just a Java file that you can download for free from the internet. And if we go open, and we just have to look in our COSMOtherm file. So I've saved my file on the desktop. So in the COSMOtherm folder, we can see the interactions between acetic acid and water. So if we look at these, if we opened them all, they'd be all the same, except for the way that acetic acid is rotated with respect to water. But let's just open this one. In this picture here, you can see that the interaction between acetic acid and water is between the oxygen on the water and the hydrogen on acetic acid. And this makes sense because acetic acid is an acid, which then likes to donate this hydrogen here to oxygen. So if there was an acid-base reaction here, this hydrogen would leave and go to this oxygen, and this would be the interaction that would take place.